I don't wanna do this. Why am I doing this? This is not smart! I have to get revenge. I wanna take him down and then kill him.
Hello, the one and only Xylophony here with another episode of Ark Scorched Earth. And today, we lost everything. So, what happened was, well, the last episode we'll call it, I went to get some dragon stuff, I came back after a bad day, the day got worse, and just all our stuff is gone. So, one like equals one rebuilt civilization. If only it were that easy. Anyway, we're going to try to do what we can and get things back up and running again. So we have the one survivor of our entire taming events, which is the moth known as Dustin, because he'd be dusting up everything. Whee! Dropping bombs! And we have materials, because we were able to pick up all the stuff from all the bodies that fell. I did end up recording that, but it also had the audio troubles as the last time, so we're just going to forget all that, and we're going to get going. So I have supplies, I have a moth, and I have my sanity, hopefully? So we're going to pick up the pieces and get going. So today is going to be some moderate taming. I kind of want to get that, but I know it's going to be bad if I go that way. Alright, let's put you here. Let's just put you on passive, like, permanently, forever and ever. Says you're on neutral now. Now you're on passive. Good, now I'm gonna go try to get this and hope those guys don't get mad and attack me. Don't particularly need that, never mind. And let's go up in here and go for that blue one. Now, I did get a couple yellow ones. They do spawn in this area. Just look at how beautiful this terrain is. Oh, hey, buddy. It is really tempting to push you off the cliff, but not smart. Anyway, here's a place I was thinking of living. As you can see, beautiful terrain. You got a bunch of little like cliff sides just jutting out in every direction. Just like bridges of land going across. And water, most importantly. There is water here. And there's a magical stream. Let me show you this stream. This stream is coming from nowhere. No, it's coming from that rock. Literally, just coming from that rock. And there's no source to it whatsoever. Just a stream pouring out of nowhere, but it gets better. This tiny little trickle of water suddenly turns into this. As it splashes down, it becomes an entire, like, almost like a stream. And then that stream turns into this pond. So, we found a place with magical water, which is good. Now, instead of just a... Ooh, is this a cave thingy over here? Let me just take a quick peek. Nah, it's just hardly anything there. So instead of living down there, I was thinking, I don't want to live, like, right there, because there's not a lot I can see around here. Like, I can see that beacon just barely because it's here, but I want to get a better vantage point. I want to, like, kind of be up on a cliff somewhere. So maybe even up across this bridge, but that seems very precarious. If I'm trying to lead dinosaurs up here, it's going to be really annoying to get them onto this spot, out of that spot, and stop giving me Adobe foundations and Adobe things. I have all those learned. So, we have, ooh, that over there, which just looks cool. I think that over there, which is where I came from, and then there's all this watery area here. But instead of doing any of that, we are going to live up on one of these cliffs. So, up here will be our new location. And hold on, there's a more specific place. Ah, yes. Right here. Now, there's multiple reasons I want to live here. One, it's close to the water. Two, it has a good vantage point. I can see all the beacons and everything spawning around me. I can see if the dragon comes in, because I did see a couple dragons while looking around. They do spawn in other places, so I want to know if it's coming. And three and four, kinda. I have this, let me get up there. I got this platform, and it's a really nice platform. I can look at the whole valley here, and I can, even more importantly, stand up here and take thumbnail pictures. Hey! So, it's very convenient, not gonna lie. Super convenient location, because it's a beautiful background on a raised platform. It's art, guys, it's art. So, we now have to go and tame some stuff. Now, Dustin could help me get out there, but realistically, there's not a ton he'll be useful for, so I'm gonna let him chill in here. I did start building some structures with those supplies I found. Well, salvaged, I guess. But then I realized maybe I don't want to live here forever, so maybe I shouldn't put so much heart into it. So I kind of made a little half hut back here.
instead of like making a full-on house. So it's an unfinished project that will possibly forever go unfinished. Who knows? But there was one other resource I was thinking of that we don't live near. Well, we might, but I haven't seen anything. In some of the yellow beacons, we found an oil pump and a wind turbine. Wind turbine we can put here just fine, but an oil pump is one thing. Now, we haven't seen an oil zone or a node or anything like that before. So I do want to keep an eye out for those. Maybe they're only in certain areas. In fact, you guys in those comments, let me know where those oil zones are. Are they similar to the water things? Are they a certain area, or are they like, I don't know, let me know about those oil things, because I should be getting some oil wherever I am, and I probably can just put it somewhere if it's close enough, and ooh, you pretty. Let me just, stop it, I want to look at that scorpion. Don't make me boomerang you. Ooh, you got hit with a boomerang. There we go. Where are your friends? Come on, you always got friends coming. You look like a... This just rock texture looks like a golem, but I know it's not, because the... Strangely enough, the rock golems don't look like what they should look like. Terror bird would not be a bad idea to have. Where'd they go? Hey. Are you guys attacking me? Yes, you are! Okay. You're not attacking me. You're just circling me and seeing if you can get me killed. All right, let's pull out this. Woo! You already go down? No, you didn't. Oh, you're running now. You're running. You know I'm faster than you. Yeah, get on the ground, level 12. Where's your friend? I heard him. You know what? Just so you don't come back to literally bite me later. There we go. You have been dealt with. Now, I do want to find your friend, because that was a decent looking one. And if he's the right level, then he's... Ooh. Yeah, I really shouldn't tame another moth. Because I tried doing some math, and they are really just... Oh, sneaky, sneaky. They're just never going to be fast enough to pull off a dragon heist. So, I want to really badly to do it with a moth. Just so I can, like, keep, you know, focused in the expansion pack stuff. But at the same time, it's just not going to be possible. Woo! Hey! Alright, so that's a level 8, and this one's 32. Hey. Hey, guys. How you doing? Ooh, a level 100. Okay. Pretty high level for one of those guys. Let's kill this one, because I don't want a lot of tames. And there we go. Plenty of meat and hide and all kinds of materials I might be needing. Alright, so this will be the first tame we're going for today. A terror bird. Not exactly what I was planning on getting, but hey, why not? Let's keep looking around. Yeah, so this is... If my base is over there and this is against the small hill... sure, there's a small chance I'll remember where it is. And if not, so be it. Alright, now, the blue beacon over there, that's where I wanted to make my home, because there's a lot of water there, it's even closer to the dragons, and, ooh, I need to cook some food. It's poop. I just need to get cooking food, so I'm gonna make some food. Let me finish my sentence first. I wanted to build over there, but there was, like, two dragons flying around that area, so I didn't want to have any part of that, like... Theoretically, I could kill a dragon, but if they keep spawning there, I'm not going to have a good time. They're going to come in and kill all my friends, so I should build in a safer place. And I should get some stuff to build a fire. So I'm going to do that, and then hopefully we'll have a terror bird when we get back. Minor problem. I remember that the terror bird can carry nothing. So let's find something else, and in fact, we might have something else right here. Let's change your aggression to passive right here. And, oh, I kind of wanted the kangaroo more importantly, but if that's a decent spiny lizard, I'll surely take him. Hey, friend. Shoot him in the butt. Yeah. He's probably not decent, is he? Yeah, 16. And there's a level 8 kangaroo here. Darn it. There's nothing. What do I get from harvesting you? Oh, yeah, I get keratin. That's what it is.
Alright, well, we got that. But anyway, now that I have this much weight, I had just gotten it down to a point where I can actually move with this Terror Bird. He can barely run with me on him, so we're going to ride him back home and then set out on foot again. And we're going to look for eagles, we're going to look for spiny lizards, and you know, we're going to take a look at this guy over here. Just a little peek, just in case he's the kind of level we want to be messing with. Oh, you can level up here. Let's give you some weight. There we go. Speed just doubles. Ooh, you're looking good. Level 12. Ooh, not interested. Level really doesn't matter. I'm just going to use him as a water tank, but at the same time, it's, you know, you gotta do it right. Ooh, there's a water node over there. Actually, I better double check it, see if it's an oil one. But I don't know what they look like, so who knows. Let's check out this guy. 28 and better. I noticed that a lot of the like weaker things don't get levels, and the stronger things easily get levels. So that's something. Yeah, this is definitely water. Yeah, and it in fact says water right there. So let's see if we can run away from these bugs so I don't have to deal with them, and we'll find something else to tame. Alright, I just nearly walked right up to where this dragon is feeding. There's nothing to risk. It's time. I'm gonna try to knock him unconscious. And I don't wanna do this. Why am I doing this? This is not smart! I have to get revenge. I wanna take him down and then kill him. Alright. How many of these darts you think I need? Like 2? 3? 400? Not right now, Sabercat! I'm gonna dart you real good. You're gonna go down instantly now. Go down instantly. Oh no. Look what you've done. Alright. Come on, world. Let's take on this dragon. Oh man, this feels like the worst version of Skyrim ever. I can't even hit him. Jeez, he's fast, man. Alright. I still didn't hit him? Oh, jeez. There we go. He's poisoned, so he's going to be hard to bring down. Alright. Why am I fighting a dragon? Because I want to fight a dragon, okay? Okay. Don't worry, Parasaur, I'll save you. I don't think I'm going to be able to save you. Oh, man, I'm trying to judge the shots. This is his last leg, isn't it? Ooh, that was a good shot. Depending on what level this is, I might not even have the slightest chance. Wait! He's down! Direwolf, not right now. All you direwolves, not right now. I'm gonna take... No! Not you either. I want that dragon. He's mine! I took him down myself. I want all the credit. Hey! Hey, stupid! I'm not gonna waste my darts on him. But I will waste arrows on him. Hey! You don't have a chance against that dragon. There. Now I have meat to tame some guys. Now I can't tame the dragon like this, unfortunately. But I can tame the wolves! Because you were being dumb. Look, you helped me, buddy. But at the same time, you almost just took my kill from me. I can't have that. Now, hopefully that dragon doesn't wake up real... Hopefully he doesn't wake up real fast. Okay. Fine, buddy, let's go. Come on. What? Ow. Sorry, your hits don't hurt me. Yeah! Now kill him. Kill him fast. Die, 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 die. How much does it take to kill you? Oh, jeez. Audio glitches, too. Yeah! We got him! Woo! We're not aiming for milk. I could have, you know, knocked him unconscious, took the milk here, but we're aiming for vengeance, not milk. So, we got it. We got vengeance. Just a little bit of vengeance. Not even a lot of vengeance. Just a little bit was all I wanted right there.
He didn't even do anything, man. He was just flying here trying to get a meal. Now I know I'm capable. I'm capable. You can now call me Dragon Slayer, because you know what I did? I slayed a dragon. No big deal. Even though it wasn't a dragon, it was a wyvern. But I got him. This dragon right here. Got him. He's dead. Let's see what we get from him. Probably a lot of hide. Oh, sulfur. That's good. Look at all the prime meat. My God. Little bits of sulfur. Tons of prime meat. That's all going to spoil within seconds. But you know what? At least these guys will tame instantly. Oh, cool. It's stacking also. Let's throw all this in you so it'll spoil a little slower than if it was on me. Apparently you're holding the sulfur now too. Congratulations. And let's see if there's any other carnivores we can bring down here to make use of that endless amount of prime meat. Because I'm happy. We took down a dragon. Now watch. Have a beautiful eagle come up here. That would be great. Let's harvest you. 16 oil. And some chitin. Alright. Good, good. Anyone else up here? Hey, eagle, what level are you? And... because our goal is going to be to get a dragon egg still. Now we know we can take on the dragons, but that was a poison one. I think that was probably one of the better case scenarios. Because the poison one, it has that line of poison that I feel like is the easiest to dodge. Let me know what you guys think, if it is the easiest to dodge, in the comments. Because I know you guys watch more Ark videos than I do. But that definitely seems like the easiest one to take down. If it did hit me, though, it would have been bad. Let's see what levels you guys are. Assault 44. Yeah, it looks like everything is kind of like set in its level ranges. Although that was a lower level dragon, to be fair. But it didn't take that much to bring down, did it? What was it, like 10 darts? Or yeah, 10 darts hitting him. But it was hard to hit him. Okay. So, let's, ooh, another water vein. These things are everywhere, even though it's probably the same one I was looking at earlier. In fact, I'm pretty sure it is. And there's one of our direwolves, tamed already. So, we got him. And direwolves, you just, yeah, you don't need a saddle for him. I haven't tamed a direwolf in a long time. So we got him, and then we got the friend over there. And we can ride out on some direwolves. Eh, this could be something. And pew! Oh. I'm not going to be taming that guy. Oh, right where I killed the dragon, where the wolf is still taming, this guy just spawned. You spawned where we were getting a dragon. Let's see. I want to tame you. Let's see. Do I have any berries on me? I probably don't. Let's get you some berries, buddy. Because I know just the name for you. There you go. Now get tamed. Because from the ashes of a dragon you have arisen, you shall be known as Dragonborn. Or Dovahkiin. Dragonborn? Yeah, we'll call him Dragonborn. It's not a bad target right there. 56 thorny dragon, and I like the look of him. Ooh. He's going after that guy right now, eh? I always seem to get you guys when you're busy. I probably don't need to use the darts to tame one of these guys. They're not that difficult. So let's just pop you a couple times. And pew. Oh, not done yet. There you go. Really? You saber-tooths are getting really annoying. Yeah, run. Just, you know. I'm just going to tame you out of principle. I gave all my meat to the other guy. So I'm going to tame this guy. He's the priority. So I just throw all my meat on the ground. And yay! Let's ride you over. And oh, the Dragonborn is he's here! The Dragonborn has come! Alright, oh, the prime meat did spoil. But let's throw some on to you. And some on to you. Not you. On to you. There we go. And, sup, bug? I just straight missed you. Eh, Give me the oil. Give me the oil. I think you get more oil when you kill them, so I've been killing them lately. At least if they're not right around my base, then I keep them alive. Oh! Over here, I actually, didn't notice I put down a, level 80 Sabertooth. You'll probably get used. That's not bad. Dodicarus, I could definitely use one of you guys. Level 20, eh. You're not full blue. If you're full blue, I'd go for you. But what else we got? Am I a little thirsty? Yeah, I'm a little thirsty. I hear something chasing me. Hey, meow. Let's get a good look at your level. Let you get real close. Ow. Yep, only level 12. Let's take you out. See if I can take him out with the boomerang. Did you straight knock him out with the boomerang? No, he got scared from the boomerang. You got scared, buddy. Oh, almost. Come on, boomerang. Help me out here. I'm chasing him. There is no running. Jeez. Didn't mean to kill him that hard. Alright, let's see what else is around here. Some Ankylos. Don't particularly need you. It's easy enough to farm. Like, metal and stuff. Good job, buddy. What level are you? 16? Hey. Nice. I guess you had that nice desert camouflage working for you. Up, I put. Ooh, I pooped myself looking at that level 70. 72 Thorn Dragon there. What's over here? I like that kangaroo. 64 Procoptodon. Maybe. What's that wolf? 48. Not bad. There's a lot of wolves in here. I guess they're kind of like insinuated jackals or whatever, but I want you. You shall be my main method of travel, Mr. Gallimimus. Alright. Yes, and he's stuck! Do-do-do-do-do! Bang. Okay, yeah, definitely gotta use darts against this guy. And oh no! Not stuck! Not so stuck! Hey. Calm down. We're gonna be friends. We're gonna be best acquaintances. There we go. Now you guys, you all saw nothing. This guy is just a humble traveler. He was my pet. He escaped. And he is now going to just take a nap. And then he'll be coming back home with me. Don't call the police. This is a complete natural cycle of nature. You either. Isn't it nice just riding through the sunset desert? Dragonborn on your shoulder. And, okay, that was a moth up there. I keep thinking moths are tiny dragons. Just because their wings, kind of at first glance, they just look a little spooky to me. But, ooh, please be my eagle. Please be the one for me. I like your colors. And, no, I don't want no level 12. I need this thing to be ready to go up against dragons. So, it's got to do its thing. So, where did I put that Gallimimus? Are you bloody? You might be the one I was talking to. It'll be over here-ish. Ooh, I spotted a really good direwolf over here and ran from it. You are not that direwolf, but since I'm taming a pack of direwolves, why not? Oh, I'm gonna have my buddy come after you, aren't I? Yeah, I am. What are you doing? Oh, geez, there's a lot of high-level direwolves. Let's just... there's a 108. That's the one I was looking at. Okay, let's get running, shall we? Do-do-do-do-do. Just on my way. Getting out of here. And that's a Carnotaur, that's an eagle. Where do I want to go? Somewhere that's not next to the Carnotaurs and eagles. Somewhere I can park my guy and then just go after these two wolves on my own. This place seems as good as any. Alright, so I am going to use the gun to go after these wolves because there's a high one and I want to tame it nice and good. And plus, I don't know how much more stuff I'm going to be taming out here. So let's see if we can find where those were. Oop, is that one of them over there? Nope, that is a bird. A terrible, terrible bird. Hey. Fine, you can die, you know what? Fight the wolf. I'm just going to kill you. Wait, something just hit me? Oh, that was my buddy. He did some work. Nice job, pal. Alright, ooh, we got a yellow beacon over there. Why you? There's a storm coming. Is that what you're trying to tell me, buddy? You trying to say that there's a storm coming? Alright, where's my wolf? Wolf? Where are you? Okay. That's what he's trying to say. I think he's trying to tell me something. Because they apparently make noises. I get it. You're acting weird. But I want you. Okay, you, sir. You can, go to passive. As I eye up this wolf over here. Yeah, I want her. And your friend might have been killed too, so. Ooh! Definitely want you. Look, buddy, I know. Oh. That was easy. You know what? You're going to be the eagle I tame. Just because if there's a storm coming, I want to get the tames and I want to get out of here. And boom, you're level 2, aren't you? Now you're level 8, I'm going to guess. 4! Yeah. I don't think we can. I'll tame it anyway. Why not? You know, sometimes things just happen for a reason. That eagle just wasn't meant to go after dragons, was he? Rock Elemental came and killed him the second he tamed. Just nah. He wasn't ready. He just wasn't ready. Okay, little guy, you were right. You were right, there is a lightning storm going on. Luckily, it's just a lightning storm. We're fine. Is everyone over here tamed up? Everyone good to go? Oh, jeez. Okay, let's go home, everyone. Let's go home. I can barely see. Come on. Okay. We have a pretty speedy crew. No one's going to get left behind, except the eagle who is already left behind. I think this is everyone. Oh boy, we don't want to go into the water. Not right now, Terror Bird. Okay, where's my place at? I'm lost. It's foggy. I don't think I'm actually in any real danger, but it is quite intimidating. So, oh no, we got into a fight with the Dodecorus. Come on, I think I got into a fight with the other guys, and then I just started attacking the Dodecorus. Alright, there we go. He's all wrapped up. Let's go, guys. Okay. Well, I'm gonna head home. And, then in the morning, I'm gonna head out tame an eagle. But I think that might be the end of this episode as the storm is raging. So, thank you guys for watching this episode of Ark Scorched Earth. I'm sorry, Scorched Earth. If you have enjoyed it, make sure you leave a like. Comment some name suggestions for these guys. I got 2 direwolves, a sabertooth. Oh, 3 direwolves, a sabertooth. I thought I had another sabertooth, but he wasn't good anyway, so I don't care. And a thorny dragon. So, leave those suggestions. I'll make sure to check them out. Name these guys up next episode. And an eagle suggestion. Give me an eagle suggestion, because I'll have one of those as well. And I already got Dragonborn. He's not changing. So, I will see you guys next time. I don't wanna do this. Why am I doing this? This is not smart! I have to get revenge. I wanna take him down and then kill him. Hello, the one and only Xylophony here with another episode of Ark Scorched Earth. And today, we lost everything. So, what happened was, well, the last episode we'll call it, I went to get some dragon stuff, I came back after a bad day, the day got worse, and just all our stuff is gone. So, one like equals one rebuilt civilization. If only it were that easy. Anyway, we're going to try to do what we can and get things back up and running again. So we have the one survivor of our entire taming events, which is the moth known as Dustin, because he'd be dusting up everything. Whee! Dropping bombs. And We have materials, because we were able to pick up all the stuff from all the bodies that fell. I did end up recording that, but it also had the audio troubles as the last time, so we're just gonna forget all that, and we're gonna get going. So I have supplies, I have a moth, and I have my sanity, hopefully? So, we're gonna pick up the pieces and get going. So today is gonna be some moderate taming. I kinda wanna get that, but I know it's gonna be bad if I go that way. Alright, let's put you here. Let's just put you on passive, like, permanently, forever and ever. Says you're on neutral now. Now you're on passive. Good, now I'm gonna go try to get this and hope those guys don't get mad and attack me. Don't particularly need that, never mind. And let's go up in here and go for that blue one. Now, I did get a couple yellow ones. They do spawn in this area. Just look at how beautiful this terrain is. Oh, hey, buddy. It is really tempting to push you off the cliff, but not smart. Anyway, here's a place I was thinking of living. As you can see, beautiful terrain. You got a bunch of little, like, cliff sides just jutting out in every direction. Just, like, bridges of land going across. And water, most importantly. There is water here. And there's a magical stream. Let me show you this stream. This stream is coming from nowhere. No, it's coming from that rock. Literally, just coming from that rock. And there's no source to it whatsoever. Just a stream pouring out of nowhere, but it gets better. This tiny little trickle of water suddenly turns into this. As it splashes down, it becomes an entire, like, almost like a stream. And then that stream turns into this pond. So, we found a place with magical water, which is good. Now, instead of just a... Ooh, is this a cave thingy over here? Let me just take a quick peek. Nah, it's just hardly anything there. So instead of living down there, I was thinking, I don't want to live, like, right there, because there's not a lot I can see around here. Like, I can see that beacon just barely because it's here, but I want to get a better vantage point. I want to, like, kind of be up on a cliff somewhere. So maybe even up across this bridge, but that seems very precarious. If I'm trying to lead dinosaurs up here, it's going to be really annoying to get them onto this spot, out of that spot, and stop giving me Adobe foundations and Adobe things. I have all those learned. So, we have, ooh, that over there, which just looks cool. I think that over there is, which is where I came from, and then there's all this watery area here. But instead of doing any of that, we are going to live up on one of these cliffs. So up here will be our new location. And hold on, there's a more specific place. Ah, yes. Right here. Now, there's multiple reasons I want to live here. One, it's close to the water. Two, it has a good vantage point. I can see all the beacons and everything spawning around me. I can see if the dragon comes in, because I did see a couple dragons while looking around. They do spawn in other places, so I want to know if it's coming. And, three and four, kinda. I have this, let me get up there. I got this platform, and it's a really nice platform. I can look at the whole valley here, and I can, even more importantly, stand up here and take thumbnail pictures. Hey! So, it's very convenient, not gonna lie. Super convenient location, because it's a beautiful background on a raised it's art, guys, it's art. So, we now have to go and tame some stuff. Now, Dustin could help me get out there, but realistically, there's not a ton he'll be useful for, so I'm going to let him chill in here. I did start building some structures with those supplies I found. Well, salvaged, I guess. But then I realized, maybe I don't want to live here forever, so maybe I shouldn't put so much heart into it. So I kind of made a little half hut back here, instead of, like, making a full-on house. So, it's an unfinished project that will possibly forever go unfinished, who knows? But there's one other resource I was thinking of that we don't live near. Well, we might, but I haven't seen anything. In some of the yellow beacons, we found an oil pump and a wind turbine. Wind turbine we can put here just fine, but an oil pump is one thing. Now, we haven't seen an oil zone or a node or anything like that before. So I do want to keep an eye out for those. Maybe they're only in certain areas. In fact, you guys in those comments, let me know where those oil zones are. Are they similar to the water things? Are they a certain area? Or are they, like, I don't know. Let me know about those oil things, because I should be getting some oil wherever I am. And I probably can just put it somewhere if it's close enough. And ooh, you pretty. Let me just, Stop it! I wanna look at that scorpion! Don't make me boomerang you. Ooh, you got hit with a boomerang! There we go. Where are your friends? Come on, you always got friends coming. You look like a... This just rock texture looks like a golem, but I know it's not, because the... Strangely enough, the rock golems don't look like what they should look like. Terror Bird would not be a bad idea to have. Where'd they go? Hey. Are you guys attacking me? Yes, you are! Okay. You're not attacking me. You're just circling me and seeing if you can get me killed. Alright, let's pull out this. Woo! You already go down? No, you didn't. Oh, you're running now. You're running. You know I'm faster than you. Yeah, get on the ground, level 12. Where's your friend? I heard him. You know what? Just so you don't come back to literally bite me later. There we go. You have been dealt with. Now, I do want to find your friend, because that was a decent looking one. And if he's the right level, then he's... Ooh. Yeah, I really shouldn't tame another moth. Because I tried doing some math, and they are really just... Oh, sneaky, sneaky. They're just never going to be fast enough to pull off a dragon heist. So, I want to really badly to do it with a moth. Just so I can, like, keep, you know, focused in the expansion pack stuff. But at the same time, it's just not going to be possible. Woo! Hey! Alright, so that's a level 8, and this one's 32! Hey? Hey, guys! How you doing? Ooh, a level 100. Okay, pretty high level for one of those guys. Let's kill this one, because I don't want a lot of tames. And there we go. Plenty of meat and hide and all kinds of materials I might be needing. Alright, so this will be the first tame we're going for today. A Terror Bird. Not exactly what I was planning on getting, but hey, why not? Let's keep looking around. Yeah, so this is... If my base is over there and this is against the small hill... Sure, there's a small chance I'll remember where it is. And if not, so be it. Alright, now, the blue beacon over there, that's where I wanted to make my home, because there's a lot of water there. It's even